The top 20 PowerPoint shortcut tips and tricks. These are not your ordinary shortcuts. Here are some surprising shortcut tips and tricks that can save you a bunch of time in PowerPoint. Number 1, proportional resize. If you've ever had problems resizing an object like a circle and it changes to an oval shape, you can actually lock the height and width proportions by holding down the Shift key. No matter what you do, it'll stay that same shape. Number 2, copy object. The quickest method you can use to copy an object is to hold down the Ctrl key and drag it where you want it copied. It even lets you select multiple objects and it'll copy them all. Number 3, keep object centered. Normally when you resize an object, I can move the bottom right corner and the upper left corner stays locked. If I move the right, the left side stays locked. And if I move the left, the right side stays locked. But let's say you want the center to be the locked position. If you hold the Ctrl key down while you resize, that leaves the center fixed. Number 4, show or hide the ribbon. If you need a little more working space in PowerPoint, Ctrl F1 will hide the ribbon. Hit it again, and it brings it back. Number 5, move slide to the end or beginning. If you have a presentation with multiple slides and you want to take one of those slides and move it to the end, click on it and hit Ctrl-Shift-Down arrow. And if you want to take a slide and move it to the beginning, hit Ctrl-Shift-Up arrow. Number 6, insert filler text. Sometimes when you're working in a PowerPoint presentation, it's helpful to insert filler text. Let's go to Insert, Text Box, and inside this text box, let's type in equals rand with parentheses and hit Enter. This fills in multiple sentences of the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. You can also select parameters. So let's do the number of paragraphs as 5 with 2 sentences in each paragraph, and it inserts text in that format. You can also insert Latin text by typing in equals lorem with parentheses. These two options are helpful to position text within your PowerPoint presentation. Number 7, start presentation. Start your presentation from anywhere by hitting F5. Number 8, group or ungroup objects. If you have a bunch of independent objects, you can position them where you want and group them by using Ctrl-G. Now they're one object that you can move together. Ctrl-Shift-G ungroups them. And now they're back to their original independent objects. Ctrl-G and Ctrl-Shift-G both work on any kind of object in PowerPoint. For example, we can come up here and insert an icon. And we'll pick this clock right here and insert it. This object now can be broken out by hitting Ctrl-Shift-G and convert it to a Microsoft Office drawing object. Now hit Ctrl-Shift-G again, and each of these independent items are separate objects now that you can move independently. It works as well on shapes, and it even works on SmartArt. Ctrl-Shift-G, Ctrl-Shift-G again, and now these are all independent objects. You can group and ungroup just about any objects in PowerPoint. Number 9, increase or decrease font size. You can increase or decrease the font size of text. Just select the text that you want to change, hit Ctrl-Shift greater than to increase the font size, Ctrl-Shift less than to decrease it. You can select an entire text box and do the same thing. Number 10, formatting text. There are a number of quick shortcuts you can use to change the formatting of text. Just highlight the text you want to change, hit Ctrl-B for bold, Hit it again and it turns it off. Ctrl-U for underline. Ctrl-I for italic. Ctrl-equals for subscript. Ctrl-Shift-equals for superscript. You can also change the alignment. To align right, hit Ctrl-R. For left, hit Ctrl-L. Center is Ctrl-E. And for full justification, Ctrl-J. Number 11, copy formatting. If you want to copy the formatting of text to another location, just highlight it, and similar to Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to copy-paste, hit Ctrl-Shift-C to copy, select the text you want to copy it to, and hit Ctrl-Shift-V for paste. That copies the formatting. Number 12, clear formatting. You can clear the formatting of text just by highlighting it and hitting Ctrl-Spacebar. Number 13, guidelines, gridlines, and ruler. Use Alt-F9 to display guidelines on your screen. Then you can adjust them where you want. And if you have an object, you can use it to snap to those guidelines. Press Alt-F9 again, and it turns them off. You can also use gridlines with Shift-F9. That also helps you align things on your screen, since the gridlines are evenly spaced across the page. Shift-F9 again turns it off. Use Alt-Shift-F9 to bring up the ruler. And here you can move things to line up on the ruler or use a combination of grid lines and the ruler. And you can see that they're evenly spaced 1 inch apart. These three features helps you with alignment on your screen. Number 14, undo or redo action. You can undo an action like moving this square by hitting Ctrl-Z. Redo that same action by hitting Ctrl-Y. Number 15, skip to slide and slide list. While you're in presentation mode, you can control things with shortcuts. For example, I'm going to hit F5 to go into this slide presentation. I can skip to a specific slide number by putting the number in and hitting Enter. So if I type in 5, Enter, it takes me to the 5th slide. 9, Enter, takes me to the 9th slide. You can do two digits as well. 10, Enter, takes me to slide 10. If you want to see a list of slides, hit Ctrl-S, and then you can select one from the list and go to that slide. Number 16, slideshow shortcuts. There are a number of slideshow shortcuts available when you're inside of a presentation. You can hit F1 to bring up the list of all these different shortcuts. Some that are worthy of note, Ctrl-L changes your cursor to a laser pointer. Ctrl-L again turns it back off. You can hit B to black out the screen, W to white out the screen, hit plus to zoom in, and then you can move around the screen, minus to zoom out, and if you continue all the way out, it shows all of your slides, and you can select one to go back into it. Ctrl-P gives you the pen drawing, where you can put lines on your screen and mark things. Ctrl-I changes it to a highlighter. E erases all of that. Or you can use Ctrl-E to turn it into an eraser and erase things individually. There are several other options available in the list, so take a look and see which ones you like. Number 17, draw straight lines. Normally, when you draw a line on the screen, it's hard to keep them level because they can move in any different angle. But if you hold the Shift key down, it forces it into 45-degree angles. This allows you to draw straight lines. Number 18, move slides. We saw earlier how you can move slides to the beginning and ending by doing Ctrl-Shift-Up arrow and Ctrl-Shift-Down arrow. But you can move an individual slide up by hitting Ctrl-Up arrow and down with Ctrl-Down arrow. Find the location you want and leave it there. Number 19, text list ordering. If you want to change the order of items in a text list, just click anywhere on the line that you want to move, hit Alt-Shift-Up arrow, and it'll move it up. Alt-Shift-Down arrow moves it down. Number 20, Mini Slideshow. Normally you come down to the bottom and click on Slideshow to begin your presentation. But if you hold down the Alt key while you click on that, it brings up a mini slideshow in the upper left corner. You can then arrow through and perform your presentation as you normally would. When you're done, hit Escape and it takes you to that slide. That's the top 20 PowerPoint shortcut tips and tricks. Start using them today to improve your efficiency using PowerPoint.
Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.